In this video, we'll explore how to efficiently load and display large datasets in Blazor, focusing on techniques to boost both performance and user experience. By the end of this tutorial, you'll have a solid understanding of how to leverage the Virtualize component to achieve smooth scrolling, optimized data loading, and quick response times within your Blazor applications. So let's dive in and get started. In this Blazor project, I've already set up the Database Context class, which includes an employee DB set to handle our data. You can find the database connection string specified in the app settings file. Remember, you'll need to modify this connection string to connect it to your own database. The full project source code is available exclusively for our Patreon supporters. If you're not yet a member, you can join our community to access this and other exclusive benefits. Just follow the link provided in the description. Now, here's our employee entity class, which includes several properties to represent employee data. Additionally, the gender and department properties are implemented as enums to maintain clear, structured data. Since we're going to display the list of employees in a table, let's start by creating a model class specifically for the table rows. In this model, we'll add a property named row number to display incremental numbers in each row. Then, we'll include all other properties we want to display in the table. I'll also set up a constructor that takes in the row number and the employee entity class as parameters. This way, we can assign property values directly from these parameters to populate each row's data. Next, let's head over to the home page where we'll display this table. In the table header, we'll add column headers for each of the properties we want to show. Then, in the table body, we'll render each of these values from our model object to display all the employee data neatly. In the code section, we'll create a method to fetch data efficiently. This method will return a value task of items provider result of employee table row model and take an items provider request parameter which helps control data loading dynamically. I'll inject the DB context factory to handle our database context creation. Using DB context factory, we'll create a new DB context instance to access the employee data. Since the virtualized component requires the total record count to manage and optimize data rendering during scrolling, we'll first fetch the total count of employees in the database. Next, we'll retrieve the employee records, ordering them by ID in descending order so that new entries appear at the top. As we only need to load data visible on the screen, we'll skip unnecessary data. The items provider request object's start index property indicates where visible data starts, allowing us to skip previous records by setting start index as the skip count. We'll then use items provider request.count to load only the required data, ensuring efficient data fetching. After fetching, we'll convert this list of employees into a list of employee table row model. Finally, we return a new items provider result of employee table row model, passing in the data and the total count. Next, we'll place the virtualized component within the table body. We'll set context to employee and assign our data fetching method as the items provider. There are a couple of additional properties we can configure. The spacer element reserves space for items not yet loaded, keeping scrolling smooth and positioning accurate. By default, it's set to a div, but we can change it to a table row for a better table structure. Overscan count allows us to load a few extra items outside the visible area, enabling smoother scrolling as nearby data preloads. Now, we'll move the table row inside the virtualized component and bind each value from the context. Before adding a few final touches to improve the table's appearance, let's take a look at how the data is populated on the screen. Once we run the application, you'll see the employee data displayed in a table. I've also added a page where you can easily create dummy employee data in the database. You can use this feature to create employee records for testing by downloading the source code from our Patreon community. On this page, you can specify the number of employees to create. Let's start by creating 5 employees. Now, if we head over to the home page, you'll see the data displayed in the table. Let's add another 100 employees to really test how the table handles larger data sets. As you can see, the data loads smoothly and we can scroll through the entire list of employees without any issues. If you open the developer tools and inspect the table body, you'll notice multiple table rows generated by the virtualize component. This initial table row is created by the virtualize component to reserve the necessary height for the scrolling experience. At the bottom, there's another placeholder row generated by the component. Now, as we scroll, you'll notice the height values adjusting dynamically. This change allows the scroll bar to reflect the entire data range without loading everything at once, helping maintain smooth scrolling performance. If you observe closely while scrolling, the virtualize component replaces the existing data rows with new data as needed. It only loads the data currently in view, significantly improving performance by minimizing unnecessary data loads. You'll also see that the bottom row, generated by the virtualize component, adjusts its height based on our scroll position, ensuring the scroll bar behaves accurately while data is loaded on demand. Now, let's explore a few additional features available with the virtualize component. First, I'll wrap the row content in an item content tag. We can use the empty content tag to specify what should display when there's no data available. Here, I'll add a table row with a message to inform users when the table is empty. To demonstrate this, I'll delete all employees from the database. Using the truncate table command, I'll clear out all entries, so the table is now empty. When we run the application, you'll see that the table now displays our custom message indicating no data is available. Let's go ahead and add some data back into the database to demonstrate the next option. We can also use the placeholder tag to specify what to display while data is loading. Here, I'll add a simple loading message to appear as the data loads. To make this visible, I'll add a delay within our data loading method. Now, when we run the application, you'll see the loading message displayed in each row as you scroll until the data fully loads. Without the delay, this loading message would be hard to notice as the data loads too quickly. I've also added 10,000 records to really test the performance, and as you can see, we're able to scroll smoothly through all the data without any performance issues. For a closer look, you can find the complete source code in our Patreon community for more in-depth clarity. If you'd like to explore more about Blazor, check out the Blazor playlist on our channel. The link is available in the description. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.